This is Jessica Brito, Delcy Martinez, and Avril Lemieux, and we're here to answer the question, is revolution the most effective way to strengthen society? In today's world, conflict, sadly, is not uncommon. But in times of struggle, people can choose to do one of two things. They can stand down in the face of fear, or they can choose to step up into the bright, intimidating light and shine back with rays of change. The Constitution says that all people should have the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. But to what extent must one go in order to achieve this? How many people sitting in this room today, by a show of hands, it doesn't matter what it's about, desire for something to improve in their life? Yeses across the board, and Jessica is here to tell you more about the topic of revolution.
The world as we know it is at many odds. So right now there are a lot of controversy on how to fix it. Revolutions have happened in the past. For one, they can be either successful or unsuccessful. The American Revolution is actually an example of this. For they have shown to shape our society as a whole. Some may say that revolutions cause only the are bad and cause the horrible act of chaos. They believe that revolutions start with small problems that then get blown way out of proportion and then sicken our society as a whole. The revolution of 1848 in Europe is an example of this, for they have only changed, for they did nothing and only caused chaos among all of us.
Now, Delcy, for the correct view on the revolution.
Revolution. We need to think as these people who desire and want revolution as leaders. And they desire that change so much. And revolutions, they create better relationships between government and its citizens, maintaining the peace, and it shapes our future.
Avril will go further into the topic about how revolutions encourage relationships between governments and their people.
Henry David Thoreau explains that all men know the right of revolution in his article, Civil Disobedience. He explains that when the government is destroyed and in chaos, that one must stand up and to better the government and better the community relations with the government. Later in his article, he explains that every man should know what kind of government would best command their respect. And that when we do this, we will obtain a better government. So when he says this, he means that we as a people should not get angry at the government and not do anything. Instead, we should think and lead the government to a better place to mend it.
Jessica, for more about the topic of revolution increasing peace in society.
Revolutions actually maintain and help to restore peace. In Tocqueville's article, Why Great Revolutions are becoming more rare, he states that almost all revolutions have changed aspects of their nations, and that these changes have made it so that inequality will be destroyed. This will lead to our society being cracked and damaged as a whole. We should instead for these people are being favorited. We should instead come together as a whole and then better ourselves to maintain the peace in our society.
Henry David Thoreau uses his grasp on philosophy in order to explain that a country subjected to a military rule and under the control of a foreign army and unjustly overrun, the people should not stand down and watch this happen around them. Instead, one leader should stand up. It is our right to rebel against a common government. And this ability to help your peers and better your entire society will lead to the restoration of peace in all around the world, causing all the people that stand up to be leaders in our society. Delcy will go into the topic about how revolution shapes our future.
Henry David Thoreau, in his article called Civil Disobedience, says that government is which best not governs at all, and when men are prepared for it, that it will be the kind of government that they will have. And it takes just one person to go against their superior, and they want that change and revolution so bad that it will give them. They will want to build the bridge to success, and they want to attain that success. Former U.S. President Barack Obama said that Rosa Parks' one significant action that she took ignited the beginning of the end of segregation. So her not giving up her seat led us on the path to who we are today as the United States.
Avril for the opposing views on the topic of revolution.
Even though all this evidence, some people still believe that we should not go with the people or become a person who goes towards revolution. Instead, they say to stop it. One of these such people are D.H. Lawrence. In his article, in his poem, A Sane Revolution, he shows his view on revolutions by saying that he believes revolutions are just for fun. People with this mentality believe that before and after a revolution, nothing changes. So why should there be revolutions if it just causes chaos and disorder? People with this mentality think that change leads to lack of security. But we should think with this mentality that modifications leads to improvement. Because if we do not believe this, then nothing will ever change and get better.
Now, I ask you all to think back to the former point made by former President Barack Obama, as he references Rosa Parks, a very influential leader in our society, and he tells about how this one individual changed the entire aspect of American society for the better. In this, he shows that Rosa Parks changed the idea that whites were more important than blacks, than that they are more important to create a very well-integrated society. Any person sitting in this room today can do the same thing because we all have the right to revolutionize society. And when we identify a problem that needs to be cured, it is our right to step up and fix that. Delcy will go further into the specific positives that will come out of a revolution.
Out of a revolution, there will be equality among all classes, so everybody would be equal. There would be more unitedness among all, and with change, respect levels would become more higher, and hatred and violence would become more lower, and it advances society.
Jessica, for our finale.
In retrospect, we should not make fun of, chastise, or even disband these types of innovative people. We should instead become them, for they think, plan, and revolutionize.
Raquel, how does your conclusion respond to any of the other research or sources you examined?
So given the sources that we examined, we found that a lot of the people in our argument were responding to revolution in a very positive manner. They thought that it was a good thing. But our conclusion went off of that, and we built off of that in order to form the fact that Although revolution is a good thing, in order to get to that point, we must identify those who think in terms of change in order to create a better society.
Jess, what advice would you have for other researchers who consider this topic?
The advice I give for these people is to go more into depth with these topics, for they give valid information on how revolutions are, and also to go into more depth on how these specific people, these changers of society, lead revolutions to what we are today, to what they are today.
Delcy, how valid and reliable are the sources you used? How do you know? And which sources didn't work?
Our sources are very reliable because we did background info on these authors and their research and their articles to see if they matched our response and if they supported us. And
Avril, explain the level of certainty you have about your conclusion, solution, or recommendation.
So, can you repeat the question?
Explain the level of certainty you have about your conclusion, solution, or recommendation.
So, I'm very certain about our conclusion because many times in society, because people have gone and tried to revolutionize, it has created a better society, like the American Revolution, which led us to become a free country.